Determine a fraction with the given characteristics. The fraction is a repeating decimal, the fraction has a denominator less than 8, and the fraction has a value less than 0.3 or a value less than 3/10. Remember, all fractions are rational numbers, so all fractions as decimals will either terminate or be non-terminating and repeating. Let's begin by looking at a fraction that we know a lot about, the fraction 1/2. Notice how this fraction 1/2 does have a denominator that's less than 8, and we should recognize that as a decimal, 1/2 is equal to 0.5 or 5/10. If we don't recognize this, there are two ways to convert this fraction to a decimal. One way is to take the fraction of 1/2 and write it as an equivalent fraction where the denominator is a power of 10, like 10, 100, 1,000, and so on. Well, notice how if we multiply 1/2 by 5 over 5, which is multiplying by 1 but produces an equivalent fraction, would give us the fraction where the numerator is 1 times 5 or 5, and the denominator is 2 times 5 or 10. So because 1/2 is equal to 5/10, as a decimal, 5/10 is 0.5. Now this method only works when it's easy to determine an equivalent fraction where the denominator is a power of 10. But it's also true that 1/2 means 1 divided by 2, because a fraction bar means division. So we can also convert a fraction to a decimal by performing long division. So if we take 1 and divide by 2, we first ask how many 2's are there in 1, and because 2 is greater than 1, there aren't any 2's in 1, and therefore we put our decimal point to the right of 1, move it up to the quotient, and now we can add a 0 to the right of the decimal point, and ask how many 2's are there in 10, which is 5. 5 times 2 is 10, and notice how because this difference is 0, we know 1/2 is a terminating decimal, 0.5 or 0.5. But again, this is not the fraction we're looking for, so we need to try another fraction. So let's increase the denominator by 1 and look at the fraction 1/3. If we recognize that 1/3 as a decimal would be 0.3 repeating, notice how 1/3 is not the fraction we're looking for. It is repeating, and the denominator is less than 8, but unfortunately the value is not less than 0.3 or 3/10. But if we don't recognize that 1/3 is equal to 0.3 repeating as a decimal, then starting with the fraction 1/3, we're not going to be able to write this as an equivalent fraction with a denominator that's a power of 10, so we'll have to use long division, where 1/3 means 1 divided by 3. So if we take 1 and divide by 3, put our decimal point to the right of the 1, add a 0, move the decimal point up into the quotient, and ask how many 3's there are in 10, which is 3. 3 times 3 is 9. 10 minus 9 is 1. So because this difference is not 0, we continue, add another 0, bring it down, and ask how many 3's there are in 10, which again is 3. 3 times 3 is 9. We subtract. Notice how we keep getting a difference of 1, and we add a 0, we get another 10 here, and so we ask how many 3's are in 10, which again is 3, which shows that 1/3 is 0.333 repeating, which we write as 0.3 with a bar over the 3. Again, the bar is over the 3 because the 3 repeats. But again, this is not the fraction we're looking for, so let's continue. Let's try 1/4. If we recognize that 1/4 as a decimal would be 0.25, we can stop here and move on to another fraction because this is not a repeating decimal. This decimal terminates. But if we don't recognize 1/4 is equal to 0.25, we'd have to start with the fraction 1/4. And if we can recognize, we can create an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 100 by multiplying 1/4 by 25 over 25. This tells us that 1/4 is equivalent to the fraction where the numerator would be 1 times 25 or 25, and the denominator is 4 times 25 or 100. 25 hundredths as a decimal is 0.25. Or of course the other option is to take the fraction 1/4, recognize 1/4 means 1 divided by 4, and perform long division. So 1 divided by 4, add a decimal point, move it up to the quotient, add a 0. How many 4's are there in 10, which is 2. 2 times 4 is 8. We subtract. 10 minus 8 is 2. Add another 0, bring it down. and ask how many 4s there are in 20, which is 5. 5 times 4 is 20. Notice now the difference is 0, which means the decimal terminates and 1/4 is equal to 0.25. Again, not the fraction we're looking for, so we continue. Next fraction, let's try 1/5. We recognize 1/5 is equal to 2/10 or 0.2. Again, we can continue because, again, this fraction as a decimal terminates, which means it's not a repeating decimal. If we don't recognize 1/5 is equal to 0.2, there are two ways to get the decimal. As a fraction, 1/5 can be written as an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 10 by multiplying 1/5 by 2 over 2. 1 times 2 is 2, 5 times 2 is 10, 1/5 is equal to 2/10, which is a decimal of 0.2. Or, recognizing that 1/5 equals 1 divided by 5, so 1 divided by 5, there aren't any 5s and 1s, they put a decimal point, move it up to the quotient, add a 0, and ask how many 5s there are in 10, which is exactly 2, 2 times 5 is 10, subtract, and notice how the difference is 0, telling us 1/5 is the terminating decimal, 0.2. But again, this is not the fraction we're looking for, so we try again. Let's try 1/6. 1/6 is not easy to recognize as a decimal. Notice how if we start with 1/6, we're not going to be able to create an equivalent fraction where the denominator would be a power of 10, so we'll have to go straight to long division, where 1/6 means 1 divided by 6. So let's perform this division. 1 divided by 6. There are no 6s and 1s with our decimal point. Up to the quotient, add a 0, and ask how many 6s in 10, which would be 1. 1 times 6 is 6. Find the difference, which is 4. Add a 0, bring it down. Ask how many 6s there are in 40, which would be 6. 6 times 6 is 36. Subtract. The difference is 4. Add a 0, bring it down. Notice how we have 40 again. So we ask how many 6s in 40, which we already know is 6. 6 times 6 is 36. Subtract. The difference is 4 again. Add another 0, bring it down. And notice how we keep asking how many 6s there are in 40, which we know is 6. So the 6 repeats, which means 1/6 as a decimal would be 0.16. Now because the 6 is repeating, not the 1, we put a bar only over the 6. And now I think we have the fraction we're looking for. Notice how this fraction does repeat. It does have a denominator less than 8, because 6 is less than 8, and the value is less than 0.3. So the answer to our question is the fraction 1/6. Now there is one more thing I do want to mention. We could have saved a lot of time if we recognize that looking at the fraction 1/3, 1/3 meets all the requirements except the value is not less than 1/3, well, the fraction that would be half of 1/3 would satisfy all the requirements. So to find half of 1/3, we would multiply 1/2 and 1/3. And notice how when we do this, we do get the fraction of 1/6, which is actually the fraction we're looking for that meets the given conditions. So again, if we were able to recognize that the fraction that is 1/2 of 1/3 would satisfy these three requirements, we could simply determine that fraction, where again 1/2 of 1/3 is 1/6, and we could have skipped 1/4 and 1/5, saving us valuable time. I hope you found this helpful.